I'm leaving this meeting right now.
That's getting cut.
This is the way.
We want it been.
Sergeant and Mrs. Smith, you're going to love this house.
Is that a tub in the kitchen?
There's no field manual for finding the right home. But when you do, USAA Homeowners Insurance can help protect it the right way. Restrictions apply.
This episode is brought to you by Skinny Pop Popcorn. Perfectly popped, endlessly delicious. Oh, so light and crunchy. Skinny Pop Original Popcorn is the snack you've been searching for. Made with just 3 simple ingredients, popcorn kernels, sunflower oil, and salt. Snacking never felt or tasted so good. Perfectly popped, endlessly delicious. Give yourself permission to snack and pick up Skinny Pop Original Popcorn today.
This episode is brought to you by Bai. It's Wonder Water. What makes Bai so great? It's simple. From raspberry lemon lime by Sydney Sweeney to Zambia Bing Cherry and Palavo Pineapple Mango, Bai has antioxidants, electrolytes, and no artificial sweeteners. So for flavorful hydration, choose Bai. It's Wonder Water. Learn more about Bai and discover all of the exotic, bold flavors at drinkbai.com.
Welcome to episode 151 of the Smugglers Galaxy Podcast, your favorite Star Wars podcast for smugglers in the galaxy. It's been a pretty freaking exciting week for me. I don't know about you guys. Jason, how you doing?
Yeah, it's exciting for me as well.
Yeah?
Yes. This is a major milestone for the Smugglers Galaxy Podcast. We've been working for this. We've been waiting for this episode for a long time for different reasons, and it's like both have intersected on the same episode. So,
all right,
pretty spectacular.
I'm curious what you're talking about. I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, you forgot about what I was talking about because you're focused on something else. But at one point this week, you did know what I was talking about. We'll get to it in a minute or two.
Okay, cool. I probably will. But yeah, dude, the freaking release of the Ghost last night just totally ruined me.
Yeah. See, you've been derailed.
You put freaking Rebels in front of me and I am done. I'm done.
We'll get to it in a minute or two. Yes. We'll get to it.
So how's your week?
Week was great.
Yeah, did you recover?
Still recovering from
poison. Oh, now
Ivy.
I see the shirt, so I get it now. Yeah. I remember. Light bulb.
Still getting off of I'm done with steroids today and I'm still getting over the poison ivy.
So did you like make any muscles or anything weird like that?
No, I haven't worked out because I was afraid to go work out with like bumps all over my arms.
Uh-huh.
Typically I'm the only person working out, but in case I wasn't, I didn't want someone looking at me like I'm patient zero for the next pandemic.
Yeah, dude, I haven't gone to workout since July. So I don't think I've been this month, but it's one of those things where, you know, July we're busy. We're doing stuff for over 4th of July. And then, yeah.
It's still July.
Oh, it's still July.
Yeah, you said you haven't worked out since July and it's still July.
Okay, well, I haven't worked out this month yet because, you know, you got July 4th and then every
we're
time.
We're changing it to June.
So every time, you know, you're like, all right, cool, I'm going to go work out tonight. And you get the phone call. Hey, my parents want us to come over for dinner. And it's like, well, that blows that tonight. And then, oh, hey, we got this going on and that going on. And yeah.
It's life has been insanely busy.
Yeah.
And I know this weekend I'm going to struggle because for the past couple weekends, it's been go, 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 go. And then suddenly I'm sitting there and I'm like, oh, I got to do something. It's like I have. The opposite of it, like the anxiety is telling me you have to be moving, you have to move, You have to do something. And I just want to chill.
Well, we have the benefit of thunderstorms and stuff the last couple of weeks. So, you know, your grass, you can't cut it. So at least you got a reprieve from that.
Yes. But I started out this year revising a book. And today I'm going to put my butt in a seat and not get up until it's done, which should only be an hour or two because I'm that close.
There you go.
Yeah. So I feel accomplished.
Jeez. Sorry. I'm at my wife's computer today because mine took a crap yesterday morning. So I'm trying to get used to everything and it's just weird. Like she's got everything set. It's just different. There's stuff in the way. And
yes. You get from.
Got Ewoks behind me.
Yeah. I get familiar with like the wallpaper, the desktop, I should say, with all the apps, or the icons on it. And then when you go to someone else's computer, I'm just like, what is this? What is going on?
I'm just glad that you understood it was me messaging you through her Facebook today, because I'm like, I'm not going to log out of her Facebook to log mine in for an hour. It's just too much of a pain. Plus, then I'd forget to log out and she'd start writing stuff on my Facebook wall.
Yeah. I knew. I sensed it through the force. It's not like Mandy's the one going to say, hey, sweet cheeks. I'm like, oh, it's got to be Glenn.
Yeah, and then you roll your eyes and be like, oh, why is he got to do that?
Why is it got to be weird? We just spooned one time at Celebration. Anywho.
It was the one time they gave us a king bed. We had no choice.
Anywho, all of that's not true. Just have to put that out there.
We had two queens. We were good.
That we pushed together. Did you pick anything up this week?
I pre-ordered the Ahsoka Starship Lego.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I have that in the news.
Yeah. And then what else did I do? Oh, I kind of backed this Haslab project last night. What about,
well, you didn't pick anything up.
No.
Pre-ordered.
Did you? I pre-ordered some stuff.
What about that E-Wing? The Lego E-Wing?
I did not know. Okay.
It's a two-pack. It's the New Republic E-Wing with Shin Hati Starfighter with Morgan Elsbeth, Balin Skull, Shin Hati, Captain Porter, and a New Republic astromech droid.
I did not realize that was an E-Wing when I saw it. I did not pre-purchase that one. So I guess we know who's driving the E-Wing now.
Oh, what did I just say? I just scrolled away from it a little bit. No, Shin Hati Starfighter. And then just, I guess, in Captain Porter. Yeah, so Captain Porter must be driving the E-Wing.
Hmm. You did notice how the E-Wing has the vintage R2 head on it. So that's kind of a cool little nod. Got to love Dave Filoni for that.
Yeah, Vintage Kenner.
Vintage Kenner, yeah.
Yeah. I picked up a whole bunch of stuff that I pre-ordered a year ago and completely forgot about.
Yeah, that's why I hate pre-orders.
We got the Black Series Jesse, which was a Walmart exclusive that Walmart decided to kick out the window when they mailed it to me from the factory. Thanks.
I gotta wonder if they get kind of like, they're like, F you collectors, we're tired of your crap.
I'm sure Hasbro goes up to them and like, you have to package it in a box. You have to put air bubbles in. You have to take care of this product. Walmart standing there with the middle finger up the entire time. You could tell us, but we're the largest retailer in America. There's nothing you can do to change our ways. We are going to make money today.
Right. It's 2 cents cheaper to ship it in a bag. It's going in a bag.
Yeah. Yeah. It was in a bag. It was in a giant bag. I also got the Black Series Talia from Obi-Wan. The Imperial version, that's the woman that was the Imperial helping Obi-Wan through everything.
Yeah.
And then I got the Black Series Inquisitor. That's the female one with the little tails coming out of the back of her head.
Yeah, she's like kind of yellowish. Seventh sister or something.
Yeah. I got the Black Series Obi-Wan Jabim. Are you chewing tobacco?
No, why?
Oh, I thought I just like...
Oh, no, I just scratched my...
Oh,
I have a coffee mug with me. It's coffee. It's just normal coffee. There's no alcohol in it.
Oh, so the black stuff went in. The brown stuff went in. It didn't go out. Mm-hmm. I didn't see that right. Sorry.
Yeah, hey, buddy. Hey, Jason, and welcome to the Smugglers Galaxy Podcast. Let me spit in a minute for you.
It is insane in a construction company, the number of people who just spit into water bottles as you're in the middle of a meeting.
Oh, geez.
It is disgusting. But anyway.
And you're at like a normal, you're at like a high class meeting too. It's not like you're at a construction site having a meeting.
My office, like we're in a building where we overlook Atlanta. You could see all of Atlanta. You could see all of Midtown, Buckhead, all of those. It's a pretty amazing thing. And then you're in this meeting. Someone's just spitting into there. Anyways, I got the Obi-Wan Jabim, which is that one where he's like running away from Vader and he's like broken down inside. I also got the Vintage Collection Tusken Warrior, which I was very disappointed because it came in bent, a bent card.
Oh, geez.
And it's from Hasbro, so Hasbro should know better. And I'm a little timid and gun shy from asking them to send me another one because the last time I did that, which was a couple years ago, they were just like, what do you want us to do? I'm like, well, I'm a carded collector and you bent my card.
You're not going to open your toys, Jason?
Don't you want me to send you another one? I'm like, I'll send this one back. You can wait until you get it. No, we'll just send you another one. And it just made me feel small.
They did send you another one?
They sent me another R2. But I'm like, I'll find one in Target someday and we should be good.
Well, you could just wait for the re-release.
Yeah.
I've had good luck and bad luck with Hasbro. Because one time I had stuff that I sent in and they're like, oh, we can't replace it. But let me send you a bunch of crap that you know, to make up for it. And then yeah. I've sent them on other things and they're like, oh, yeah, it's working fine. I'm like, it's not working fine. But, yeah. You know, I guess it's a pop shoot or whatever.
I also got a second box with a bent card Weequay, and I'm like, if there's one card to bend, it's got to be this one because it came in five other figures. Mm. And that Weequay I'm opening and putting on the Sail Barge.
There you go.
So I'm happy that was it. But then also I got the TBC Darth Vader, the one with the removable helmet, the Han Solo from the Endor bunker, the Weequay, and the clone Captain Hauser.
Nice.
It was busy.
Sounds busy, like a busy great week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, that's it. You've been hitting up Walmarts and Targets. Have you seen anything?
The only thing I've seen was the Inquisitor ship at the one in Holly Springs. And it's like two of them. It's like, oh, we don't have room on the shelf. It's a brand new product. We'll put it way up top where nobody can get to it. So That's the only thing I've seen. I'm thinking Target with them clearancing everything out is kind of waiting on a restock or a reset. So I'm kind of staying away from Targets for a little bit. But I haven't. I don't know why I thought that we'd get stuff here in Georgia, especially like the AT-ATs. But the AT-AT I've got is ordered from Target. So
yeah,
I don't think my wife's going to be happy with me here soon because I was looking at my Amazon account and you've got the Ahsoka Starship. You've got the Ghost Lego. You got those two Lego pieces. That's $200. Then you've got the AT-AT that's getting ready to hit sometime at the end of August, 1st of August. And then there's like five or six Micro Galaxy Squadron that's going to hit 1st of September. So the Amazon. And then you've got the Ghost, which is going to hit. So there's going to be about $1,000 worth of crap that is going to hit in about a week. And I don't think she's going to be happy with me.
She loves you.
Yeah, she does. She, we'll get into the story from last night here. Oh. It was just funny. It was just one of those husband wife moments, you know, cause not that she had a bad day at work, but she had a bad day at work and I'm watching the Haslab thing of them announcing the Ghost. And I just backed it and it's like 10 years in the making. And then she's like, you're not listening to me. I'm like, no, I'm not. Cause I've got people dinging me on Facebook going, dude, are you okay? Are you okay? What's going on? And I'm just like, I'm trying to look at my phone and she's like, pay attention to me. And I'm like, so that was my evening
that sounds like fun.
Oh, it wasn't bad, but then she realized, I think we both kind of came to the realization that we both needed a moment and we let each other have the moment and then everything was good. Plus I cooked dinner. So she loves when I cook dinner.
Oh, okay. bonus points, brownie points.
Brownie points.
I have some news. Lots of news. Lots of news.
Lots and lots of news, man. I think San Diego Comic-Con got more news than freaking Celebration did.
Oh, I am completely behind then with the SDCC news. The only thing I know from SDCC, I have a cousin who's there on the floor, and he met Max. I told him, go talk to Max. He's pretty cool. He's the brand manager. So he did talk to Max. I don't have the details to that conversation, but he's like, hey, do you want me to get you the Jazzwares exclusives? I'm like, yes, yes, yes. He's like, I'll see what I can do. And so he goes over there, and the booth was shut down by the fire marshal. He says it's the second day in the row where the booth was shut down because there's just too many people. So they weren't letting anyone in. Is that possible at a con like this?
Dude, I don't know. That's like, interesting, though, because I know like Max had posted on one of his social medias, like if you walk up to him and be like, give him a code word, that he'd give you a like the fourth series blind box. But I didn't know that they could shut down a thing. I mean, I guess that's good for Micro Galaxy Squadron. I'm hoping they, that means good things for them. But
well, it's the Jazzwares booth, so it was like Halo and Squishmallows, and they had another toy line.
Yeah, I bet Squishmallows had a lot of people there because that's more of a pop culture con.
Yeah.
I just want Jazzwares to do good, because that means if Jazzwares does good, that means Micro Galaxy Squadron is going to do good. And, you want everything, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You want the company as a whole to do good.
Yeah, I do. I don't like the 1 in 500s. The con exclusives, that's unnecessary. And that's even more limited to the people on the floor, because it's whatever.
I understand. I the 1 in 500, make it like 1 in 2,500 or something. Make some extra ones, but because Funko does, everybody does a San Diego Comic-Con or a New York Comic-Con or a Celebration exclusive. I'm used to that in the collecting world. It's when you have the blind boxes or you have the other stuff that we keep griping about that stinks, because the con exclusives, they always step it up like 2-3 notches.
I like what they did with these, the storyboards. I know that like there's some complaints that the A-Wing is the sequel trilogy A-Wing, not the original trilogy A-Wing. There's some slight differences, but even with that said, I like that illustration look, because they do look like someone penciled it. It's got some distinct lines that you would only see in a hand-drawn
It looks comic booky, like if you because they didn't, like Hasbro or Mattel or somebody released some comic book looking figures, and it's that style of paint app. I forgot where I was going, but yeah, those are they stepped it up, because the boxes are amazing on those. They like took it up 2 or 3 notches on those boxes.
Yeah.
Because it's not the normal standard box.
No. So it's a little frustrating. I can't get it, especially since I like the look of it, but it is what it is. Don't hate the player, hate the game.
Well, I was also talking to one of the guys last weekend who goes to the cons, and he was saying like the one last year, the hologram one was like $40. The hologram TIE Fighter.
These this year are 20, so.
Huh. Oh, he might have been wrong. He knew they were more money.
That's maybe it is. Maybe the cost to make it transparent was a different plastic and a different cost. I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyways, Justin Simien, director of the new Haunted Mansion movie, was also the showrunner on the Lando Disney Plus show. He's making the rounds right now, obviously promoting the movie, because he's the only person who can do that since the actors and the writers are on strike. He spoke to the direct and he said, I'm certainly poured my heart and spent a lot of time working with them and put this together a really great show. It feels like everybody loves it. And, I was told we had to put a pause on it because of scheduling, and the next update I got was in 2020, some years ago. So I don't know. I have no idea what's going on with it. If you remember at Celebration London, Kathleen Kennedy, when asked about the Lando Disney Plus TV show, she said it's still happening. So time will tell.
Yeah, I want to see that show, because I really enjoy Donald Glover, and he does such an awesome job with Lando.
Yeah, I wonder if it's his schedule and not Lucasfilm's schedule.
Now it's everybody's schedule, so
yeah,
there you go.
3 years ago.
Well, shoot, Stranger Things got pushed back to like 27. Those kids will be like smoking and drinking
because of the writer's strike. But it sounds like this show is written and ready to go. We just need to put Donald Glover in front of a camera.
Oh, geez.
But he's busy too because he's one of the IT kids. And I know he's not a kid, but one of the IT people in Hollywood. He's everything he does turns to gold.
You're right.
Leading up to San Diego Comic-Con, Hasbro went ahead and announced a couple items. First was the Return of the Jedi 40th Anniversary Retro Box Set. It included a Gamorrean guard, which if you look at him, he looks like he's seen one too many things in his life. Admiral Akbar Yak Face, newly sculpted Mon Mothma with Leia gun, which we'll get to in a minute. Wicket and the Emperor's Royal Guard. This will be a Pulse Shop Disney exclusive. Mon Mothma looks amazing. It's the same thing we were talking about way back when we had Ryan Shaw on. There's a factor of like, it doesn't look like it's hand sculpted. Just go ahead, get up and leave in the middle of a podcast. Sure.
Dude, you know, sorry, too much coffee.
You good now?
Yeah, you were saying Mon Mothra.
Mon Mothra, that's a different kind of action.
I figured you could just vamp for a minute because you were like, all right, cool.
Well, yeah, I was good for a minute, but then I was going to get into the opinions and wanted to get your opinion on things. So first of all,
yes.
Anyways, I'm keeping most of that in.
Good. Hey, look, there's Kanan. So
Mon Mothma comes with Leia gun. Now, I know there's a lot of jokes about what Akbar and what's the guy, Maydeen, they both come with like a staff.
Yeah.
It's like, what do you do with the staff? But Mon Mothma, of all people, would not have a gun. I just don't see that happening.
I don't. It's a cheap out way of Hasbro, I think, because then they don't have to produce another weapon.
Maybe. It is Leia's blaster.
So, I mean, they were probably like, well, how can we save money? We'll put her with a blaster. Nobody will care. And dude, there's more pressing things, I think, than Mon Mothma being packaged with a blaster.
Yes.
I mean, they could have put her with nothing, and then they would have bitched and been like, oh my God, she has nothing.
I mean, that's more appropriate, I guess.
She should have had like some... She didn't really hold anything, did she?
She doesn't hold anything, and she's become a more popular character now that she's in Andor, and she's also going to be in Ahsoka, so I mean, it's just a matter of time before she's on the big one, The Mandalorian.
Yeah, that...
Genevieve O'Reilly has played Mon Mothma more than the original actress in Return of the Jedi.
Yeah. Well, she was only on the screen a few seconds, wasn't she?
Yeah. Yeah. So, Yak Face.
Dude, that's one that I'm going to gripe about more than... I'm not going to gripe about it, but... I mean, we all knew it was coming. We do... For a crappy podcast, we've got some pretty decent connections. So you do hear the rumors. We've heard the rumors for like the last year and a half that they were going to re-release Yak Face and the Blue Snag. So here's the first domino falling. I've seen them do it with Transformers for the last 4 or 5 years because they keep re-releasing like the OG Transformers. And I'm sort of, it's, how should I put it? It's bittersweet for me because I see both. I'm very good at seeing both sides of a story. And I've already got my Yak Face. I don't think Yak Face, watching what happened with the original 12 backs when they did the original run of the retro line, I thought that 12 back prices would drop. It didn't touch 12 back prices. So if you wanted a 12 back, you were still looking for an original 12 back. It was a very few. I mean, people still looked for the retro line, but because it was a new line of figures, it wasn't because they wanted a cheap 12 back. I don't think them releasing that Yak Face is $600-$700 loose right now. He could lose. He could use a correction.
Yeah.
Because I paid like $225 for mine in 17. But then again, it also opens the door. I mean, you're with them releasing this figure, you better be on point if you're buying a Yak Face. and you think you're going to, you know, you need to see the COO and you better trust the people. I would not be buying a yak face off of eBay anytime soon.
No, which might bring the cost down.
Right. Which is also, I mean, there's also guys like Stan Solo who's making a yak face and making a blue snaggle tooth and stuff that unless you know what you're looking for, it's hard to tell. And I mean, the one way to tell is always look for the COO, always look on the back of the legs, because like this one, it'll be a computer generated COO where the old school ones, they're raised on the, you know, it's a engraved type thing, or it's not engraved. It's the opposite of engraving.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a difference between what you just said, like that individuals are trying to purposely trick people into buying it and remaking it and then making it a little, what's the word? They're blurring the lines between real, what's original and what's not. And it's like, you could do something. You could add extra toes to yak face or something along those lines just to show that, you know, it's not, or add toenails or something like that to show that it's not, you know, I know he's wearing boots, don't yell.
Right. It's a difference between a bootleg and a custom.
Yeah. So it's happening. I would assume that blue snaggletooth is next and vinyl cape Jawa. I have no evidence that that might happen, but those could be the next targets, because when you see that, you know, it's $1,500 to buy a loose vinyl cape Jawa, well, I'll just go buy that one for $12 or whatever the case may be.
Right. And I mean, if you're looking for a placeholder, that to me is more acceptable to spend the $12, you know, on a yak face, on a retro. I mean, you can't buy that retro yak face. And I don't think anybody, because it's coming in the package.
And yeah.
So I don't think anybody's going to separate that for, you know, so want to separate that package.
Right.
Or so, that's set. That's the word I'm looking for. But yeah, I just, you know, people be careful, because there are some people that are not honest out there.
Mm-hmm. Or people who are honest and they don't know what to have.
Exactly. So always ask to see the back of the legs, because you'd be surprised the amount of people I'm like, hey, can I see the COO? And they're like, the what? I'm like, let me see the back of the leg. And then they go, oh, okay.
Yeah. So then, in advance of San Diego Comic-Con, Hasbro announced a new vintage collection, Jabba the Hutt, 88 and Salacious Crumb. 88 will be carded and Salacious will be on another mini card. And to that, I have a few words to say. One voice is all it takes to move a mountain. No task is too large. No effort is impossible. It took 10 years to land a man on the moon. 10 years of calculations, engineering, training, and passion. 10 years of sacrifice, giving it 110% of their time and energy to go further than anyone has gone before. That passion carried them 238,900 miles through space, and on July 21st, 1969, that passion and dedication allowed Neil Armstrong to take his first step on another astral body in our solar system. The first time in human history. It goes to show dedication to a cause can be fruitful. Nothing is impossible. So raise your voices and be heard. I'm reminded of our favorite movie when a small band of rebels oppressed by tyranny and imperialism stood together and fought back against their oppressors. They raised their fists to the sky and said, in one voice, you will no longer step on us. We deserve dignity. We deserve better. And that small band with that one strong voice facing total annihilation by that imperial force blew up that armored battle station with nothing more than a fool's hope. They did that 3 times, by the way. And on the 3rd time, it was a lot like the first, but I digress. The power of the people should never be ignored, overlooked, or have their voices quieted. Some said the task was too great. Others doubted our efforts. But we knew better. We campaigned, and we demanded. We raised our voices. We tirelessly, selflessly, campaigned for it. We close out every episode demanding that Hasbro re-release VC66, and I'm pleased to announce we were heard. This is why on July 18, 2023, nearly 54 years after the first human stepped on the moon, Hasbro announced, after years of raising our voices on this podcast, shouting it at the end of every episode and making our desires known to the proverbial mountain that couldn't be moved, Hasbro, the company currently responsible for making Star Wars action figures, listened to the voices of these hosts and decided to give the people what they wanted. They will release VC66 on card. That's right, listener, we did it. Salacious Crumb is back. Salacious Crumb will be re-released on a mini card. The efforts of one small podcast paid off, and together we moved mountains. Our campaign was a success, and you, dear listener, can share in that glory. You owe yourself a debt of gratitude to that hard work. I'm reminded of what President John F. Kennedy said 61 years ago in his famous "We Choose to Go to the Moon" speech. We choose to ask Hasbro to re-release VC66 in this decade, not because it was easy, but because it was hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we were willing to accept, one we were unwilling to postpone, and one we intended to win, and the others too. And to sum it up, I think there's only two words that can describe this effort. Ladies and gentlemen, listeners of this great podcast and great doers in the world, those two words are mission accomplished. Remember, when you open your Vintage Collection Jabba and you pull out that mini carded Salacious Crumb, you can smile and feel proud. You are part of this momentous effort. You can thank your friends at the Smugglers Galaxy podcast. This will be a day long remembered. Shoot for the moon. After how many years? Two and a half years,
and you looking at what's her face going, "Hey, could you release VC66? And she just looks at you and goes, "Nerd."
Yeah, so here it is. So in Celebration Anaheim, we were setting up the Georgia Alliance of Star Wars Collectors, our booth, and we had some time to kill because, unlike Hasbro, it takes us 15 minutes to set up the booth, and Hasbro, it takes them a whole day.
Dude, that 15-minute setup time is very much on purpose so that I can get into a convention 2 or 3 hours ahead of time, get that shit set, get that stuff set up, and go.
That was also 15 minutes with 5 people helping.
Well, we had a lot more going on at Celebration Anaheim.
Yeah. But while we were there, you know, I was doing my YouTube videos, and I was walking by the booth, and it just so happens that Emily, who works on the Vintage Collection, was setting up her figures, and this is the quick conversation that we had.
We watch all your live streams.
Awesome.
You're famous to us.
Thanks, guys.
Good work with the Vintage Collection.
Oh my gosh, thanks. I've made so many troop builder packs that I've built an enormous posing project for myself.
If I had one request.
Shoot.
Re-release VC66.
Which one's that?
Salacious Crumb.
Salacious Crumb? Alright, I'm gonna log everything I've
Thank
been
you.
Asking for.
Thank you.
Right.
I know it's a pipe dream, but I can dream.
That and a Sabine helmet.
Oh, Sabine helmet's coming too, I'm
sure. Sabine helmet's coming.
Oh, it's still going back there. Hold on, now it's going through my microphone. Okay.
I think that Sabine helmet's coming. Dude, when you showed me that post, I was looking at it because at San Diego Comic-Con, of course, they have everything for the Ahsoka show at San Diego Comic-Con, and you showed me the screen used Sabine helmet. I'm like, all right, who just made that?
Yeah, I thought, too, the same thing, that it was a Hasbro release that I missed, but no, it's just the screen used one. But yeah,
never mind.
What?
Well, no, I thought when they were going in the role play yesterday at the thing, and I was like, oh, they're gonna release the helmet, and it was still something cool, but it was not the helmet.
No, it was what, Ahsoka's dual lightsabers.
The dual lightsabers for Ahsoka, which are pretty badass, but they're not the ones from the show.
No.
They're not the ones from the Ahsoka show. They're the one from Clone Wars.
Yeah. Which people love. So it's like you can't win. But anyways. Yeah, that was us talking to Emily back in 2022, last year, 21?
When was it? Yeah, it'd have been 20. Are we 22. In 23? Yes, it'd have been 22.
It was a year ago. Yeah.
Yeah, 22.
And I did not squander the opportunity to ask her to re-release that. And I'm sure she went back to the board and she said to everyone, we have to do this. And
this very nice looking guy with salt and pepper hair said that he wanted VC66 re-released.
Yeah. And they obliged. And yeah, it's coming. So they did say it's released on a mini card. They didn't go into further details. We don't know if it actually says VC66, but the intent to re-release Salacious Crumb is happening. And I would imagine what's going to happen is that the original release, that San Diego Comic-Con exclusive in the Death Star set, was released on a Revenge of the Jedi card. And I think they're going to do Return of the Jedi this time.
Hey, at least you're getting it.
Yeah, I'm happy. Ahsoka's T-16 shuttle will be released on... It's the Jedi T-6, not 16, 16 from A New Hope. For Lego. It's coming out in Lego. It's going to include Ahsoka, Sabine, Professor Hang, Huang, and the show's new Inquisitor, Merrick. Did you pre-order that? Yeah, you said you did at the start of the show.
Yes, and yes. There's one reason why I pre-ordered that. Sabine. Can you guess? Yep.
Sabine. Have you heard the rumor that Merrick Inquisitor is actually Ezra?
Really? I hadn't heard that rumor.
Yeah, that might just be people chatting online. There's no... I don't think that's a spoiler. I don't think that's actually true.
Yeah, I've also heard that it's the other lady that she faces in Mandalorian.
Morgan Elsbeth?
Yeah. I heard that rumor. I haven't heard the Ezra rumor. That would be interesting. I could see them pulling something like that. I mean, you would have to have Thrawn, I think, introduced a lot sooner in the series, but I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see.
I could see it. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. It would be shocking, but I wouldn't be surprised by it.
Yeah, would Filoni do that to one of his characters? I don't know.
Probably. I don't know, but you don't know. I mean, to throw it a new wrinkle in there, it'd be interesting to see on the Lego piece because with a lot of the Mandalorians, instead of putting a face, like the first round, like when Boba Fett first started coming out, they just had a blacked out head. They had no face on it. So it'd be interesting to see if that's what they do with that figure.
We'll see. Morgan Elsbeth, I think, is getting her own action figure. And I think that Inquisitor is too. So I don't know. Let me race through the first half of the Hasbro panel from San Diego Comic-Con, because I know the last half is what we're probably going to be talking about for the most of this episode.
Yes.
The Jazzwares. So we're recording this on Saturday, and Jazzwares is having a panel at 2 p.m. our time, Eastern Standard Time, 11 a.m. West Coast time. So we don't have the information for that. We'll have that next week. But they first announced the Black Series Pre Vizsla from the Clone Wars, which is interesting because I thought they would hold off on that. And then if that actor appears in season 4 of The Mandalorian, then make the figure. So it's like they might have to redo the entire thing if they can face print it.
Yeah.
Then they went ahead and announced the latest wave of the Black Series holiday line.
He does have the Darksaber, right?
Yes, he does.
Okay, good.
Yeah, we'll get to that. And then a Jawa in red capes with a monkey lizard, a green monkey lizard, an Ewok with a porg, and that Ewok is painted to look like the Yeti from the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, just like the Womp. Was it Womp? No, Chewie. Chewie was painted white with the blue fingernails.
Yeah.
Just like the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer Yeti. And so the Ewok will follow that same pattern. He'll be pretty much white with blue nails, and then he'll have a green. It's got to be Wicket. A green.
It's not. It's Paplu.
Paplu,
I think. It's whatever. It's not Wicket. It's the other Black Series one they came out with.
Yeah, Paplu was the first one. Death Watch.
And that's a cowl.
Cowl, thank you. I was going to say scarf or cloak. Death Watch Mando with a sweater deco. It's a blue one. That one doesn't seem special. I mean, none of these seem special, but on the pecking order, the Jawa's first, followed by the Purge Trooper painted.
Why
to
would
like...
the Jawa be first?
Because it comes with Salacious Crumb. the green one. That's what I...
Is that a Black Series version of him, or what's?
Yeah, that's the Black Series. Actually, we should get into that real quick because I did look at it. It's not a straight re-release of VC66. They've updated it. And what I think they've done is they scaled down the Black Series version to 3.75 because the limbs are wrong, the arms are wrong. But if you compare it to the Black Series, it looks pretty similar. So I think that what they're doing is just re-releasing the Black Series, which they've been doing. That's the speeder bike situation.
Yeah, that's what they do. I mean, that's what I think they did with the Thrawn. It looks just like the Black Series Thrawn. Except the card's different. So sorry, yeah. I'm jumping ahead.
No, it's a good point. I didn't even think about that. So the Purge Trooper will be painted to look like a Nutcracker. I mean, I'm not going to buy it, but I do like the look of that. The K2SO, the KX droid is painted white with, he comes with a BD unit from Jedi Fallen Order and Survivor. That's a BD unit, right?
BD.
I think it's BD. Snowtrooper painted to look like a snowman, which confused me at first because I was watching, you know, crummy video from someone's camera in live streaming from the place. And so they throw this image on screen and I had trouble. My brain couldn't wrap its mind around what I was looking at because I know that Hasbro is not going to produce new pieces. They're just going to repaint things because that's cheaper. But the nose for the snowman was painted like half a mustache almost, like that describes it right. But from screen, it looked like it stuck out. So it wasn't until after the presentation that I saw the professional photos that I saw that it was painted like a mustache kind of coming off on one side of the mouth. But I thought that one looked cool too. It looked like a snowman.
Yeah, they made comments about that during the live feed, how it paint just, that was the only way they could really do it unless they put a projected nose on it.
And then,
I guess they could have done coal, but whatever. I'm sick of second guessing Hasbro.
And then they released or announced the Vintage Collection Life Day Chewbacca from the Vintage Collection. It's the same sculpt that they have been using for like 15 years now. They haven't updated Chewbacca in a while, so maybe that's the new call of action for this podcast is to get a new Chewie. But
they gave him a new hand.
Yes. New hand with a new orb so he can easily celebrate Life Day on Kashyyyk. But I thought it was a cool figure. It's a Shop Disney exclusive, so you're going to end up paying like $30, $25 when all said and done because it's $17 for the figure and then it's $8 for shipping or something like that. So
yeah. To
have a Shop Disney exclusive, it's an expensive exclusive. And then TVC Sabine in deluxe box packaging. I cannot tell you how much I detest the box packaging. It's almost like Hasbro's trying to find ways to save money by not using that bubble.
Yeah. That's a badass looking figure, though, man.
But yes, it is.
That face sculpt is pretty much dead on. It's probably one of the better face, one of the best, you know, better face sculpts I've seen.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's going to go August 11th, so I got to figure out, is that going to be Hasbro Pulse or Amazon?
Yeah,
or?
It's that. I actually didn't write down the exclusivity. There's some that I know off the top of my head, like the Chewy, because I was like, I want that. Where do I get that?
Mm-hmm.
But some of them, it just went in one ear out the other. I don't think that one's exclusive.
Okay, well, then if I can order that off Amazon, that'll make things a little bit easier. And I don't care about how the package shows up because that thing's getting opened. That's a dude has got a loath cat. How could you do? Oh my god, they're tugging
save
at
it.
Heartstrings on these
breathe.
Rebels.
Breathe,
they
save it. Breathe,
and of course, my heavy breathing is probably not getting picked up by Zoom. So,
no, it's not, it's canceled it out.
I'm heavy breathing, I'm trying to calm myself down.
The Vintage Collection Ahsoka is the same that was released on the Mandalorian card back. It's the exact same figure. It's just got an Ahsoka card back now. So,
and they actually admitted that during the presentation. They're like, oh, this is a re-release.
Yeah, it's nice for them to acknowledge that and to hear that we're going to call it out. So there's nothing special about that Sabine. And even when they...
Not the Sabine, the Ahsoka.
Ahsoka, yeah. Even when they do the Imperial officers, they did comment like, no, not that. Was it Thrawn? Thrawn. Well... So one of the ones they announced was the Vintage Collection Thrawn on the Rebels card back, and they did call out that the pants were like reused, but there's a new torso or something like that.
Yeah, it looks the same. The what I've seen, the head sculpt looks the same as the Black Series, because they had made an effort to say, oh, this is like the animated version. And I'm like, it's not like the animated version. But now that I'm talking about it, they did that on all the Black Series Rebels. They made them look more lifelike and less cartoony.
Yeah. And I didn't like the card back, because the card back is the animated version. And
yeah,
they specifically, well, maybe this is tied into the ghost, the Haslab ghost, but for the most part, and so for the most part, it's supposed to be the realistic version of the character in the Vintage Collection and in the Black Series. It's supposed to be, if you take someone from animation, you put it in one of these toy lines, it must look real.
Okay.
And then the card backs, they went out of their way, because at the end of the original run, they had the Clone Wars, Obi-Wan, Anakin, and Ahsoka. And instead of putting an image there from the show, they went ahead and they Photoshopped something to make it look like it's real. Mm-hmm. So then they released the Tartakovsky Vintage Collection version with, they updated the figure to make it look real, but the card back itself wasn't Photoshopped. It was a screen grab from the show, which I didn't like. They said, well, this is a celebration, so it's different. And then I saw the Thrawn with a cutout image or a still from the TV show, from the animated version. I'm like, this is not what it's supposed to be. This is not supposed to, it's supposed to be real, you know, and they mm-hmm. didn't do that. But it's got to be because it's a special occasion, because the Haslab goes.
Well, I think they've...
that they makes hinted, sense.
Yeah, I think they also hinted pretty heavily, and listening to you talk about it, I think with that they're going to be releasing some more Rebels in that, with that card back. And I think they're going to stick with that aesthetic on all the Rebels card backs.
Okay.
The way it sounded to me was that was the first of the Rebels card back. And that's what they were going to stick with.
Well, going back to the Black Series, they next announced the Black Series Hera, which looks like she's from the show.
Yeah, it's from the Ahsoka show, which is right. Oh, that one looks good. That looks good.
Black Series Sabine.
Yeah.
And Yakface this morning pointed out that when you look at the side art, because sometimes the art from the side of the Black Series bleeds into another, it looked like Ezra's shoulder and his little gauntlet that he wears on his arm.
Well, they're going to have to make it. It only makes sense. I don't know if that's going to get me back into Black Series or not, even though it's Rebels. I probably will end up buying it, but
you'll
I think
it.
I need to focus on the TVC, dude. I need to fill that ghost, dude.
And then Black Series Ahsoka was announced. This one will be on Ahsoka packaging, but it's the exact same Ahsoka that was released with The Mandalorian.
Yeah.
They did announce a TVC pre-Vizsla, so they had the Black Series version. This is the new version for Vintage Collection. And they've reverted back to the original card back for the Vintage Collection, which I'm very happy with, because it gave some history on the figure.
Yeah.
Which I felt like was missing in the latest versions. It looks more like a classic I'm looking at one right now, because they call out, like, the other figures you can get with this line are these. Back then, there was a swoop image. There was an image of the original version of the figure. There was some data or facts about the original release of the figure, the character, stuff like that. So I don't know what this looks like. I haven't seen it close up, but there is the swoosh. There is a call out of the image. I would imagine it's some sort of brief history about the character.
Yeah, I dig that one. I did think calling out the card back, the Yak Face actually like ran an early image of a card back that had the Thrawn and stuff on it that Hasbro had set up in their booth. And then later on in the show, somebody had taped over it.
Yeah. Got to think this stuff through, guys.
Yeah. So anyway. Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, I don't know. I was going to just add in some, hey, yeah. Yeah, right.
I'm trying to get through this fast so we can get
Do
to
it.
The big one.
Do it.
The Black Series R2-D2 on, I don't know, the Galaxy line, the one that's on the store shelves now. It's the same one that was released the 40th anniversary, I think.
Mm-hmm. No. And the one of the original ones.
Yeah. So this is the new sculpt of R2-D2. It's been released in something else. I think it's the 40th for Return of the Jedi, but I can't remember. Then they announced a Vintage Collection Revan, which is from Knights of the Old Republic. It's an all-new sculpt, so maybe we can stop complaining about that like we were doing VC66. There's a lot of people in the community that talk about that Revan. The Imperial 4-pack of Officers, which is that builder pack, but it's, I don't know, it's not that special anymore because they charge just as much now for those figures as they do as the regular ones.
Yeah.
They teased a 3-pack, so then they went into like their pipelines. They teased a 3-pack with Cal Kestis, one of the Inquisitors, one of the fifth sisters or whatever from the show, seventh sister, I don't remember, and then a Purge Trooper. So those will be coming soon. I believe that one's an Amazon exclusive. They also did the Super Battle, not the Super Battle Droids, the Droidicas, the, what are they called? The spinning Battle Droids, the ones that roll out.
Those are battle. I thought those were Super Battle Droids.
I thought they had a different name.
Ones with the shields on them.
Yeah, so that one's coming to the Black Series.
That was cool.
That might be a cool figure to get. Then they also announced the Super Battle Droid from Attack of the Clones. And then they're going to release the Battle Droid, the regular one with C-3PO's head.
Yeah.
Which, cool.
Yeah, I think that's something people have been wanting.
Yeah. I was showing people last weekend, like, when little kids would come over, whoever, they didn't know better, I would show them the one after the 30th anniversary, and they released the Battle Droid with C-3PO's head, but then the same package, they just released the opposite. So C-3PO's body with the Battle Droid head.
Okay.
And so those were chases that you had to chase down. So because of that, and I like that figure so much, I'm happy to see that, and I might actually buy that Black Series figure.
Cool.
And then they did some quick pipeline reveals for the Vintage Collection. Axe Woes, the Mando commander that kind of flies back and you think that he's the spy in the last episode, in the last couple episodes of The Mandalorian Season 3. He's a face character. Mando Season 3, Grogu Season 3 with the Season 3 Pram, Finn from Rise of Skywalker, which is surprising to see anybody care about that movie from Hasbro. Because it seems like that's something everyone's like trying to forget or something.
I think that may be a way to get him back into the fold.
Yeah.
Because he's had his, and now all of a sudden he's like, well, maybe I'll come back and play Finn again.
Yeah. Show me the money.
Yeah.
Andor is going to be released, but it's the same jacket as the previous released version. So I'm like, what? There's so many different looks for Andor. There's the TV show. There's the movie Rogue One. It's like, give us something else, because don't re-release the first figure you had for this line when you relaunched it.
Yeah.
And then what?
Nothing.
Okay. Phase One Clone Trooper, and then Count Dooku, which is another character that fans of the Vintage Collection have been asking for like a couple years now, and he's a major character in the prequel trilogy, so it's good to see that. Retros reveals real quick. Qui-Gon Jinn, Obi-Wan, Darth Maul, the Battle Droid, Jar Jar, and Queen Amidala. I thought those were pretty interesting. I can't wait to see what a retro prequel character looks like.
I'm interested in Darth Maul should be cool. I think the Jar Jar is going to be you never know. Jar Jar's kind of had a rebirth a little bit. People are starting to like him. And I think it's part of the fact that the kids that grew up with that series is now old enough to start buying their own crap.
Yeah.
And have disposable income. I'm trying to think. So you said Queen Amidala, Jar Jar.
Darth Maul, Battle Droid.
That would be kind of cool to see.
Yeah, I want to see what a retro Battle Droid looks like. I wonder if it's like ED-8? I can't remember.
Yeah, the torture droid.
Yes, the one that comes with the Jabba set that's not Salacious Crumb, that's carded.
The tan one or the white one?
No, the white one, not the "you are protocol droid, are you not?" Not that
yes.
guy.
Not the Mark Hamill one.
Yes. And then, Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan. Interestingly, there's no Anakin there.
Yeah.
I'm like, why no Anakin? That's weird. He's the main character.
Yeah, I don't know.
Anyways, that was it. They closed down the panel. They said everyone goodbye, and everyone left, and they went home, and the end.
Right. They're like, we're not releasing anything in Hasbro, in the Haslab. We haven't been teasing anything for the last 6 months.
So what happened?
They finally announced it. They finally announced a ghost after 10 freaking years of waiting for that ship to come out. They finally announced a Haslab of the Ghost. I'm trying not to get emotional, but it was, I knew it was coming, but it was definitely, I got emotional when they started announcing the Sabine and the, and then you see the Loathcat. And, you know, just the little things like that as a Rebels fan, you really appreciate. But they announced the Ghost, $500 with 8,000 backers to get it to produce. And you need 17,000 to get release all the tiers. And I'm hoping if it goes more than that, they'll release some extra tiers, which would be cool. But you never know. I don't know.
I hate to squash, pop the bubble, but I don't think that's going to happen. I think if they get to 17, there's nothing beyond that.
Okay.
The last time they hit all the goals, which was the Razor Crest, which had 28,000 backers, there was nothing else after the last tier was unlocked.
Well, there's stuff that they could still produce, but anyway, long story short, it's going to be freaking huge. Did you see there's video of a guy bringing it to the table and he's basically holding it with his arms spread?
Yeah.
And I'm just like, I knew it was going to be big. And then I knew what they were waiting on. And I'm like, I need to see scale because they're showing pictures of it with Hera in it. And you know, okay, Hera's sitting at the table and it's huge. And you're just like, this thing's going to be massive because there's so much room. It's one figure and it's just, whoa. And yeah, it's 3 feet wide. I mean, we are discussing redoing. I have to reorganize my room. I have a futon down there. I got to get rid of that futon to house the ghost, have room for the ghost. It's that big.
Do you use the futon ever?
No.
Yeah, there you go. Go.
Yeah, that's what Mandy was like. It's nice to have to sit down there, but I can put a couple of chairs down there and be just fine. So, I mean, literally, we were talking last night and Mandy's like, we never use that futon, get rid of it. So I'm going to have the futon with a couple of end tables and put the ghost on it and wear it next to the, probably do the Razor Crest and the Cantina, but we'll see. I don't know yet. I've got a year to plan it all out. Long story short, it comes apart. It comes with the Phantom 2. They did kind of cheat some stuff on it, but if they weren't going to cheat it, they would have had to make it huge. It would have been twice the size.
The Phantom?
The ghost. The whole thing.
Oh, the whole thing. Yes.
The whole thing. If because they cut two bedrooms out of it. And like you were saying, like the top of it, which I kind of figured they would, like the top that you kind of see where the loading dock, I don't think they have that in there in this ghost.
There's three different levels to the official ghost. One does have like a hallway at the top. Then there's the base level, which is what you have in the Vintage Collection version, minus two bedrooms.
Right.
And then there's the place where they store things underneath.
Yeah.
So.
So they cheated the dock door, but I don't think it goes anywhere. I can't tell for sure.
It does, because when you land it, you can open the dock door. You can't really store anything in it, but there is a section where there's a ladder that goes down to that level.
Okay.
So you can like have a figure hanging there, but if the figure falls off, it goes into that docking thing, so you can pull it out there. So it does connect. It's just, I don't see any adults or any kid trying to climb the ladder with, you know, one hand underneath the ghost and the other hand on top of it, trying to pull the figure out once he clears the hole.
It looks awesome if you have it landed with that front open. It looks really cool. It's cool that they at least did that. It's got the gunner seat underneath, which moves in the front, and it's got the gunner seat up top, which kind of borrows a page from the Lego ghost that you could pop it out and put a figure in it and put it back in. It doesn't look like it's very deep. That one's very detailed.
That's Jazzwares too. They did the same thing with their Falcon.
Yeah. So that's borrowing a page out of those. All four chairs are right out of the show. The cockpit's right out of the show. I think they really, if they had to nail something, if they had to do something right, they did it right on the cockpit, because that's like what everybody sees in that ship. And then you kind of can guess what everything else looks like. But the one part that they had to nail, they nailed. Because all four chairs are different. They're, you know, right out of the show. What else? It comes with the Phantom 2.
Yeah, the Phantom 2. And so the question I had was, originally, Chopper is permanently stuck in the Phantom 2?
That's what it looks like.
Yeah, I didn't like that.
I don't like that either.
Like, just charge us the $600 and make the Chopper removable from the Phantom 2, and so I can pop them back in. I didn't like that aspect.
That's one of the things I don't like. I've got two gripes, and we can get in that in a minute once we go through the tiers. But it's just me being a nerd.
Yeah.
So
as we record this morning, I'm pulling up Hasbro Pulse. It's Saturday.
Go ahead. Do it.
53.74 right now. This thing will be funded by Tuesday by the time this episode drops.
The way that it's going, yeah, it'll be fun. And I have no doubt. I mean, I may have a doubt, but I don't see why it wouldn't hit 17,000 backers. Because there are guys that it's like, once it hits this certain point, I'm ordering three or four of them.
Yeah, you can order up to five, which is like, I see what you're doing there, Hasbro.
Yeah, so I think, but there again, you know, my wife was like, you're not ordering... My wife was looking at the tiers, and she was just like looking at the figures, and she was like, oh, you almost need two of them. And she goes, don't freaking think about it.
Would you be opening your figures?
Yes.
Okay.
I am going to be very careful when I open the figures. I will cut the bubble and I will save the cards. I will get the cards in acrylic because those cards, now I'm going to lose it.
Okay. Let's go. So tier one is Ezra. So with the figure, with the vehicle itself comes one figure. It's Hera, comes with their favorite fruit and her Calicori. The card backs all look like the family painting that Sabine painted at the end of Rebels. Come to find out, Dave Filoni actually drew that.
Wow.
And that's the image that they use. But these cards were someone else. And Ryan pointed out this morning who painted these. So it's not the Filoni drawing. And you can't do that because like half of Zeb is covered by Sabine. And if you had Sabine and Zeb on the front of a card back, it's like, what's going on? Who are you selling here? So they did change it up a little bit.
Because they did, because on the in the family portrait, they're overlapping. Yeah. And on the card backs, it's individuals. So they did redo the card backs. The art on the card back.
So that's a tier one with 11,000 backers. I don't think that's going to be a problem. I don't see that as a struggle.
No, Hera comes with the ship.
Oh, sorry. Hera comes with the ship. Ezra's 11,000. Sorry.
Yeah, you're fine.
He comes with a Loftcat and his painted biker scout helmet that flips up just like in the show. So, you know, he can wear the helmet and then flip up the front half of the mask and see his face, which I like.
Yeah.
Kanan comes, if we get to 14,000, he's the second tier. He comes with an alternative head in case you want to recreate the moment that he dies.
Yes, that is in the last episode of Rebels. That's after at the beginning of Jedi Knight, he does have does cut his hair, and it's the heads from Jedi Knight. Yeah.
It's weird that you packaged. I mean, it's a pretty iconic scene, but this is my diorama here where Kanan is standing on top of a gas container. And no, it's not going to happen.
You, there's no real way of because you need the gas container and you need that ship and you need Sabine and Ezra. Then you could.
Don't challenge me.
It'd take a lot to reproduce that scene.
Don't challenge me.
You're sorry.
No, I'm joking. And then, the final tier, tier three at 17,000 is Garzeb Aurelius, also known as Zeb. He's a big figure. He's carded. He doesn't really come with anything extra other than his weapon. He is a season four Zeb. I don't know if that means
all these
anything.
Are season four.
Yeah. So that's where we stand with the Razor Crest, the Ghost. Sorry. I'm trying to do two things. I'm trying to make my notes as I talk.
Yeah. I think if they didn't come with things that to me are iconic, like the Calicori, to me, the Calicori is something kind of special for me and my wife because a couple of years ago she found a 3D printed version of it and made it up for me as a Christmas present. So that kind of holds a special place for me and her. And like if it didn't have the Calicori, if Hera didn't have the Calicori, if Ezra didn't have his biker scout helmet. If Kanan didn't have the alternate head and the mask, these figures would not be getting open. But to me, they need to be open, and it's just they've got too many iconic accessories that are only going to be available on those figures to just let sit in a bubble.
So let me just say a couple things, and you can just dive in. Yes. And gush. Yeah, so the card backs, obviously it's a special thing. It's the Haslab. And so when you put those up against like Thrawn from Rebels, that version of the card back, I think it looks good.
Yeah.
It's just Thrawn with the rest of the vintage collection doesn't look good. I do like the animated look. I do like how they use that drawing, which is both in the Ahsoka show and in Rebels. And then finally, I just wanted to mention, and you can go on, the price number, the price for $500. I was expecting $600. I was sitting there watching this, waiting it, and then, oh, $500. Of course I'll back that. And I wonder, did Hasbro release a $600 figure like you tell your parents, oh, I got a D in science. You got a D? No, I got a C. Oh, okay. Suddenly a C doesn't look so bad. So did they release the $600 figure, and then when it's comes time to actually order this thing and see $500, we're like, oh, that's not bad.
Maybe, because when I told my wife, I was like, it's $500. And she goes, wait a minute, it was $580. I'm like, well, that was $50 shipping and $20 taxes. She goes, well, it was $600 then. It wasn't $500. So I think they may have prepared you for $600 because it was taxes and shipping. Released it at $500, which this thing wasn't as bad.
You could have ordered Pulse Premium for $50 and then
get
free
shipping.
Dude, I
did email them. I was so excited, and I was like, oh, I gotta back this. And it was just such a, oh God, I gotta get this done, that I probably should have done that. But I did email them to see what they say.
Okay. So go ahead and gush. I was just looking at the card backs. The high res versions have just hit the internet.
Oh, have they real? Dude, those card backs are freaking beautiful. I'd love to see what's on the back of them, but as a Rebels fan, as a fanatic, those cardbacks they freaking nailed them out the park. And that's going to, I think they did that on purpose to tug at people's heartstrings. I'm really excited that they did the animated versions of these versus the Ahsoka versions, because they do kind of get you both ways. It is like, oh, the ghost from the Ahsoka show, but no, it's from Rebels. I know it'll back because the numbers, they just keep climbing. Every time I look, I'm watching this like I do a freaking package from UPS. it's the truth. I'm checking it. If I'm on my phone, I'm like, let me see what it's at. And it's already at 5,500. I mean, and it's less than 24 hours. So that's exciting to me. I hope they keep climbing. I want it to hit the 17 because I want that Zeb. I really want the card back. So my plan for the figures is I'm going to open them, but I'm going to take the card back. They make an acrylic case that you can keep a card back in, just a card back. And I'm going to display those because it's an iconic scene from Rebels. They did, I think, the best they could with the space they had. With the ship, the back of the ship, it would have been nice to have the extra bedrooms, but I don't think we need them. The common area, I think, is more important, but I don't understand. You know, they have like that bench and stuff, which I'm assuming the common area, they took a lot of stuff out of Ahsoka to make.
Yeah, because they said they worked with Doug Chang and Filoni to talk about it. So,
okay. I missed a lot of that just because, like I said, my wife, when after everything dropped, she was like, I had a rough day at work and we're trying to have a moment, you know, hey, how you doing? And I'm like, they dropped the ghost. I just spent $600 on the freaking ghost. So she was kind of like, and of course people are dinging me and
yeah,
it was an emotional time. So I had a lot going on. So I didn't really watch, I need to go back and watch that, but so I have a feeling it'll be a good mix of both shows. I did look at because it needs to fund by September 6th, which
third.
Is the
is it third?
It's the 6th, which is it's a Wednesday. Or I thought I saw the 6th. Which
7th. It's the 7th.
7th? Okay. Well, that gives it 3 weeks of Ahsoka. So they were smart with that. So you've got 3 weeks of Ahsoka to get this thing.
So in the fifth episode, we're going to expect the ghost to blow up.
Yes, exactly. I don't, that ghost ain't going nowhere, man. They gotta keep it going for Heir to the Empire.
Then it can blow up.
Something's gotta happen. Well, they're gonna let Jason take over it. Let him fly it around. Him and Chopper going around the galaxy. All right. So my complaints with it, and this is just me being a nerd. I'm upset that they didn't have Chopper be a full size figure.
Chopper and Sabine.
I'm getting there. Oh. Jason. I'm getting to Sabine, but yes, the Sabine thing pisses me off too. Jason is like, oh my God,
you yelled at
me, Dad, you yelled at me.
And we spoon together. Don't yell at me.
It was really weird being the little spoon, man. What was up with that?
Sorry. Anybody who meets me online, when they meet me in person, or meet me online first, when they meet me in person, they're always like, you're much bigger than I thought you'd be. Like, what size do you guys imagine me at? Am I 5'2"? Like,
well, I think both you and I, we're about the same height, and it's just, I don't know, maybe we're both big dudes, and it just, it's
maybe. Anyway, sorry.
It's funny because, anyway, long story short, the more time we spend together and the more time our wives spend together, they're like, you know, you guys are the same person.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. I'm just a little bit more
raunchy.
Raunchy. So anyway, I think the reason, all right, so, and then Sabine. Yes, we're getting a Sabine in TVC, but it's Sabine from Ahsoka. It's not Sabine from Rebels. And yeah, she wore the same outfit in Rebels, but it was 5 years after the Ghost Crew broke up that she's wearing that outfit. And that is my favorite Sabine outfit because it's just black and purple. It's a really badass outfit, the Jedi Hunter outfit. I wish they would have had Sabine with the ghost in season 4 before she went to Jedi Hunter. I think that it loses something with that, even though I'm still going to buy that Sabine to put with the ghost. It's just not right. But I'm also thinking it's Hasbro. They're going to use that Sabine, put a new head on her and repaint her. And then you'll have Sabine from season 5. I think they're going to do what they always do. They're going to re-release all those figures for people that didn't back the ghost in the TVC line, because they're not going to waste those sculpts. They're not they're not going to just use them for the ghost.
Yeah, they will. They're supposed to be. They said this is exclusively for the ghost, the Rebels version in the sculpts.
Right. Oh, really?
You weren't paying attention. Yeah.
Dude, yeah. I had to clean my glasses when I was done watching that, because I cried so much. I was bawling. It was bad. It was bad me watching that. And I knew it was coming. And just knowing that they did it, it was like freaking watching the epilogue all over again. Go ahead.
You're excited.
Just a little bit. I literally, when somebody had said on the live feed that it's backing, and I was like, oh crap, they've already backed it. I think I was number 150 to back it. Or at least when I got there, it was like 150 backed.
Yeah.
So I was trying to get in to be one of the first ones to back it.
I think you're also one of the first to get shipped at the backside of the project.
Really?
I think
Well, there you go. That was I think within 30 minutes it was already at 1,000.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I backed it pretty early on.
Cool. That's good to know. I think the reason why I'm not going to get into the Black Series is because I'm waiting for the TVC stuff to be released, because I want the proper Sabine to go with the ghost.
Which is it, the Rebels version or the?
Even if I want the season 4.
What's the proper
four
version?
It's season 4 Sabine, which would be the Rebels version.
Yeah. Okay.
Of her. And I want a full-size Chopper, which I kind of already have, because Disney released a 3 3/4 size Chopper. So I could cheat it with that if I had to. But then they needed to do something where Chopper, you can delete that panel, because I know they did it in, didn't they do it on one of the X-Wings?
Mm-hmm.
Where you could delete the droid if you wanted to?
Am
I imagining that?
I don't remember.
But there was, I think there was one ship where you could take that panel, because all it was the droid head. You could take that panel out and put another panel in. Not necessarily put a droid back in there, but you'd have the slot. It would be empty.
That Disney Parks Chopper is selling. There's people on eBay asking $125, but there are some people asking for $80, $60. So even the Rebels version is going for $80, which stinks because I never got that.
I think I have two versions, because they did the Disney Parks, which was in 2017 Celebration. They released it at Celebration in 2017.
Yes.
And I bought that at Celebration. And then I found the Rebels version when we were in Chicago at the Disney store for like $10. I was like, I'll have that. And when I was at Second Chance, I think I bought the Rebels version loose. So I've got both loose.
All of this to say that it's expensive. And if you're going to re-release Yak Face, you might want to do that with Chopper too, Hasbro.
Yes. I think they're going to have to. They're going to have to re-release. And you've also got... And then you've got the Ahsoka version of the crew that you're going to have to release.
The one thing I will say for you that I'm happy, and I hope this trend continues, that with the Sail Barge, which was released 4 years ago, there's been like a non-stop slew of support for the Haslab Sail Barge. Like, they released that little corner of Jabba's palace where Han Solo lowers down from the carbonite. They released a bunch of build-a-pack figures so you can build out the skiff. They released the skiff, and now they're releasing Jabba's palace. So there's just been, for the past 4 years, it's just been continued support of Return of the Jedi, and I hope that if the Ghost funds, that you'll get a whole slew of support for that in the Vintage Collection, and maybe even play sets and stuff like that. So I don't know, because it's not a movie, if Rebels will get the same love, but I hope that for you. I hope we get, what was that Devil's guy? Even Hondo. Let's get a Rebels version of Hondo. And
that would be badass.
Get a Rebels version of Princess Leia and Lando. And, you know, anyone who's really been on the Ghost, let's do that.
Yeah, they had said something like, there was a lot of iconic people that have been on that ship in the presentation. So I think they're kind of going to do that, but... I mean, because you could do, I mean, yeah, there's a ton of things that happened on that ship, and they left it open, the back end of that open, where you could put a lot of people in there. And I don't even know how I'm going to display it. I mean, the only thing I can think of is I'm going to put everybody in the cockpit and just call it a day.
I have no clue where to put this thing.
Dude, I'm already, like I said, I'm already planning. It's going to have to go down to IKEA and buy a couple of more coffee tables and kind of take that thing out, the what's it called, out of the shit, oh shoot, I can't even think right now,
the coffee maker.
I'm so excited, take that futon out of my futon. Out of my collection room, because that's really the only thing I can't really, because on the back of that futon is a case that I've got to get into from the back, so I can't really put anything behind there. I got whatever I put there, I have to be able to move,
yes,
to be able to get into that case, so I can't put a whole shelf there, but I can put a couple of coffee tables that I can move fairly easily. My wife was actually like, how heavy is that thing? Will the coffee table support it? I'm like, it'll be fine. I'm ecstatic with this. It's a good time to be a Rebels fan, man. It is. We are finally getting our dues, you know, getting the, not respect, but we're finally getting what we want. We've been wanting love for all the years. We're finally getting the love as Rebels fans.
Yeah. Well, I'm happy for you. This thing will fun. We're going to have a Vintage Collection Ghost in our future in another year or so.
Yeah. That's what I was talking to my wife about it. And it's like, okay, we won't know till September. We won't get charged till September. And then it'll be another year. So, I mean, we've got tons of time to figure things out.
Yeah, but it looks great. I like the painting on it.
The outside of it's beautiful.
Should be a good project.
Yeah, there's actually somebody had asked, because they released a Phantom a few years ago.
Yes, yep.
And that Phantom One is it looks fine next to it, but it's too big to fit into the ship.
Oh, that's a bummer. Well, see, maybe down the line, if they want to continue to support the Vintage Collection Ghost, they'll do a Phantom One that fits on it.
That would be cool. You can definitely tell on the Phantom Two how they scaled down that ship, because in the cockpit you could fit two or three people, and in that cockpit you can only fit one person.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think you can put anybody in the. I don't think there's a cargo hold in it. Which, because I think if there would have been, they would have shown it, huh?
It kind of folds out. It's like one of the first things you see in the video.
Okay.
But you can't really store anything in there, to be honest. Like, it's so small.
Right. What I love about that whole video is it's like all these pieces are moving, and it was like, pieces do not move by themselves.
Yes. Just in case you were going to back this thing because you thought the pieces move themselves, let us just get the lawyers in here and tell you, no, that's not the case.
Well, it's just like that one person who went to an automatronic dinosaur exhibit and complained that the dinosaurs weren't real.
I'm sure that happened, yes.
It did, dude. I'm
sure it did.
It's like, dude, yeah, you wouldn't be here if the dinosaurs were real, buddy.
Right.
They would have eaten your ass.
Yeah, or they would have evolved to be smart enough to hunt us and eat us. I don't know. That's the same right. thing. Same ending. Forget it.
Right, exactly.
So, anything else? It's a pretty busy week.
Yeah. I think I'm good. We got, what, the 23rd? We got a month to the Ahsoka show?
Yep, August 23rd. Next weekend is the Powder Springs Toy Show, so to check that out.
No, the 5th is the Powder Springs Toy Show.
Isn't it the next weekend? Or is there a weekend between those weekends?
There's a week in between.
See? I don't even know what day it is.
It's the 22nd.
Oh, so there's, 29th next weekend is Saturday. Oh, okay, never mind. So I get 2 weekends to chill.
Yeah, the 5th is a Powder Springs Toy Show.
The 12th is PowerCon, which I'll be attending. So if you see me, say hi and say, wow, you're much bigger than I thought. And that's pretty much it. Oh,
yeah,
you
well,
Legion
Joelanna.
Con.
Joelanna's the same weekend as PowerCon.
And Legion Con?
Legion Con is August.
Saw that too.
August 19th is Legion Con.
Oh.
And our buddies over at Nerd U, they are having next Friday, the 28th, they're having their grand opening celebration.
Congratulations to them. I don't know if I can do that, but congratulations.
Yeah, it's in Commerce, so I'll head up there right after work. So it'll still take me like an hour to get up there and then like an hour and a half to get home. But it'll be cool. It'll be cool seeing those guys.
Real quick, I just want to let everybody know that Rogue Fun Weekend, a 3-day event showcasing the passion, knowledge, talent, and contributions to the Star Wars collecting hobby by those living in the state of Georgia, will happen Friday, May 3rd through Sunday, May 5th. This collector-focused event will include panels, open collection tours, special guests, food, swag, and most importantly, our friends across the country. You do need to be a resident of the United States. No, I'm just joking. But you do need to be a member of the GASWC, because that's where we're going to be promoting it. So if you're not, go ahead and do that. If you want to participate, it will be limited, and more information will come this fall.
Yes, it'll be a fun time.
And then thank you for listening to the Smugglers Galaxy Podcast. If you could, please leave a like and a 5-star review of the show anywhere you listen to podcasts. It really helps us out and points people to our show. Follow us on social media. You can find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Send us an email or message us. We love feedback and love to make you part of the show. Our email address is smugglersgalaxy@gmail.com. Thank you to Alfonso Riviera for the Smugglers Galaxy logo. And thank you to Levi Waterhouse for the music. Hasbro, thank you for releasing VC66. Hashtag vote with your wallet. Sabine will be on next week. Pass on what you've learned. Be a positive force in the collecting community. This is the way.
This is the way. Back the ghost. Back the ghost.